and today I'm going to share with you the research I have done on smart gun technology. Gun control debate has been in the forefront since the recent mass shooting at Parkland, Florida at the Stoneman Douglas High School. As a result, many people have been debating the veracity of the Second Amendment. Arthur Schlesinger has said that the interpretation of the Constitution is changed over the course of history as a result of the introduction of mass media. Back in the 1700s, the initial intention of the right to bear arms was to protect ourselves from a tyrannical government. Now, people use it for more social and cultural reasons for their arguments. So what are smart guns? Smart guns were developed by Kai Colfer, an 18-year-old, who integrated military-grade technology with existing weaponry to create a weapon that only fires if the person has the corresponding fingerprint or watch or wristband to wear with the gun. Now, today I propose the question, is the implementation of smart gun technology on the civilian market an effective way at preventing gun violence? I believe we can explore this through my multiple perspectives and find that the solution is that implementing it on the civilian market will have a considerable impact on gun violence in the United States. To better understand the types of smart gun technology, we can take a look at the biological and radio frequency identification. The biological one, developed by Kai Colfer, requires the user to put their fingerprint on the trigger and only then can they fire the weapon. The other type is the radio frequency identification, or RFID. This type of weaponry requires that the person wears a corresponding watch, ring, or bracelet in order to act on the trigger. Now, one major dissident of smart gun technology has been the National Rifle Association, or the NRA. They argue that the implementation of it, even on the civilian market, is the first step in gun control. They're also saying that it is unconstitutional because it violates our Second Amendment right. While the NRA may be correct in saying that implementing smart gun technology and making it constitutional world across the United States does violate our Second Amendment right, but just adding it to the civilian market is just an addition, and people have the option to purchase technology, which still makes it constitutional. As a response to gun control, this is in no way a step towards gun control. It's only limiting the access of dangerous weapons to certain individuals that it could be harmful to. Now, another major player in the smart gun technology realm is families. Families are currently the largest buyer of smart gun technology. Many families want to keep guns in their house, but are concerned that their kids might find access to these dangerous weapons. Smart gun technology takes all of these fears away, as it allows parents to secure their homes while still keeping their children safe. A preliminary study found that 65% of families were willing to buy the additional biological identification appendage to add to existing weapons in order to secure their home further. Another perspective that is crucial in understanding the smart gun technology debate is the state of New Jersey. In 2002, lawmaker Loretta Weinberg passed a bill in which requires all guns within the state of New Jersey to have RFID technology attached to them. Now, as a result, Loretta thought she was taking the right step in combating gun violence and making smart gun technology readily available, when in fact she did quite the opposite. Now, people hear the term smart gun technology and immediately equate it with gun control as a result of this restrictive law. As a result, the technology, which is centered in New Jersey, has suffered because they're having a difficult time breaking the market of New Jersey, considering all of the economic activity in that area with these products. Now, smart gun technology is a wonderful solution to combating gun violence in the United States, as it restricts the access that people have to certain types of dangerous weapons. But there are several limitations that arise. One limitation is the expensive nature of these products. A Case Western Law Review by Kimberly Tyler cites that the average identification biological fingerprint lock costs on average twice as much as the gun itself, meaning these products are extremely expensive. And some people aren't willing to purchase technology because of the high price tag. But many say that once these products become more readily available on the market, the price will go down and people will be more interested and the cycle will continue. There's also evidence that suggests that implementing this can reduce gun violence by 25% in the United States, which is a significant number, considering almost 33,000 people die from gun violence in the United States alone every year. And this technology has a potential to save lives. And in most people's eyes, it's hard to put a price on life. So smart gun technology is an excellent way to save this, despite the expensive nature. Another fear people have is the unpredictability of this technology. This technology can be easily manipulated, similar to unlocking an iPhone. If the person had the correct fingerprint, they would be able to unlock the gun and potentially do more harm than good. While many people are speculating that this technology is new and underdeveloped, there have been no instances in which this has actually occurred, so there's no way to say for sure that this technology is not reliable. There has also been evidence that suggests that the RFID could be easily hacked via computer, but nobody has successfully done this yet, so there's no way to say one way or the other. Now that we have seen the limitations, we can take a look at solutions to how to end gun violence in the United States. And it seems that implementing smart gun technology on the civilian market would be in a very effective way at preventing gun violence. By adding it, it's just a safe addition and people have the option to purchase it, so this makes it a safe and constitutional decision to ending gun violence. So today I asked the question, is implementing smart gun technology on the civilian market an effective way at preventing gun violence? And we can see that indeed it is. Smart gun technology has proven itself to be successful in trials, and we've seen that the technology has the potential to save lives, and its introduction could do a lot of good, considering the previous statistic I mentioned said it could reduce gun violence by up to 25%. Thank you.
Okay, how did your research question evolve as you moved through the research process? Did your research go in a different direction than you originally planned or hypothesized?
Yes, so to answer the first question, initially I did want to research gun control in the United States and how the cultural differences between the North and South affected this, but I ended up changing gears because there wasn't a lot of concrete evidence one way or the other, and I stumbled upon smart gun technology, which is a fairly new development, and I decided to incorporate that. And initially I was going to say, is it constitutional or not, but obviously implementing it is, making it mandatory is unconstitutional, so I decided to change it to, would the implementation of it help with gun violence in the United States?
What might be the real world implications or consequences, like influence on others' behaviors or decision-making processes of your findings? What are the implications to your community?
So I think that smart gun technology overall seems to have a lot of benefits, as it does reduce the amount of access people have to dangerous weaponry, but there is the argument ultimately that if somebody wants to find a gun, they will find a way to do it. So it can't solve every problem, but it can solve the instances in which a child stumbles upon a dangerous weapon and fires it accidentally, or one statistic I found said that 1 in 5 cops that are shot with their own weapons. So maybe implementing this in a police authoritative setting would help. And I'm sorry, could you repeat the second part?
The second question is, what are the implications to your community?
Absolutely. So I think that smart gun technology would help, considering we live in an area where gun control is heavily debated. I think the implementation of it on the civilian market would be effective because people that are opposed to it can have the ability to protect themselves while not worrying if their kids are in any danger because of the weapons they keep.